بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم رب زدني علما صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم آمين الحمد لله رب العالمين. In this lecture, I will discuss the important concepts of geometric progression with examples. For this lecture, I am using the work of one of my best student, Ms. Laiba Gulzar, of class 2021, the Lyceum. An important advice for me and for everyone: we must be compassionate. Geometric progression, or GP, a sequence which has a common ratio R is called a GP. For example, the sequence 2, 6, 18, 54 is called a GP because each term is 3 times the preceding term. 2 times 3 makes 6, 6 times 3 makes 18, 18 times 3 makes 54. The constant multiplier 3 is called the common ratio. And you can also understand this in this way: the ratio of any two consecutive terms is constant. Like 6 upon 2 is 3, like 54 upon 18 is also 3. So if the ratio of any two consecutive terms is same, then the sequence is GP. The notations used for a GP are: small a means first term, small r means common ratio, s, small n means sum of all or n terms, all means n, and this notation means sum to infinite. Percentages. Well, r can be in percentage. For example, if it's given 5% increase, then r will be 105%, which is 1.05. If it's given 10% decrease, then R will be 90%. That will be 0.9. If it's given 15% of the previous year, this means neither increase nor decrease. So R will be 15%, which is 0.15. The structure of a GP. The first 5 terms of a GP are A, AR, AR2, AR cube, AR power 4. If you observe the structure with respect to the term number, then you will see that this number is 1 less than with respect to the term number. The power of R is 1 less than the term number. See, this is 3, this is 4. So you can also write the structure for Tn. T5 is AR4, so Tn will be ARn minus 1, because this is 5 minus 1. So this is the nth term formula of GP. T9 is AR8, T10 is AR9, so Tn is ARn minus 1. This sum, Sn, of a GP. The sum of a GP can be written as, this is the formula of the sum of GP. Just need to learn this formula. A times 1 minus R to the power N divided by 1 minus R. You can use this formula whether R is greater than 1 or less than 1. When, like, whether R is positive or negative or greater than 1 or less than 1. No problem, you can use same formula for both. The infinite geometric series. An infinite sequence is a sequence whose terms continue forever. For example, consider the infinite progression with A2 and R half. So it begins. See, first term is 2, the second term is 1, because second term formula is AR. So when you multiply A with half, you'll get 1. Third term is half, fourth term is 1 upon 4th, fifth term is 1 upon 8, and so on. This is S1. The sum of first term is 2. S2 means sum of first two terms. 2 plus 1 makes 3. S3 will be 3 plus half. So S1 is 2, S2 is 3, S3 is 3.5, S4 is 3.5 plus this, S5 is this. So we can work out the sum of the first n terms. The sums are getting closer and closer to 4. See, this number is getting closer and closer to 4. We therefore say that the sum of this sequence will be 4. Well, because the sum of the first n terms gets as close to 4 as we like and gets larger, we write the sum of this series is 4, this infinite series. So we also say that the sum to infinity of this series is 4 and that the series converges to 4. A series that converges is also known as a convergent series. Hence, S infinite would exist. See, sum of this infinite series is 4. So S infinite would exist. And this is the formula of S infinite, A upon 1 minus R. And this would only exist when R lies in this range. When R lies between minus 1 and 1, then sum to infinite would exist. This is the condition for an infinite geometric series to converge. So whenever it says S infinite exists, then this is the condition for the infinite geometric series. This is the nth term formula. We already have discussed this formula and this formula as well. S infinite, and this is the condition for S infinite. R must be in this range for infinite geometric series. Common ratio R. Well, it is the ratio of any two consecutive terms. For example, T2 upon T1, T3 upon T2, T10 upon T9. For three consecutive terms, for example, T1, T2, T3, we can write R in this way. Like T2 upon T1 is R, T3 upon T2 is R. This formula is very important. We always use this formula when three consecutive terms are given to make the calculation simple and fast. For an AP, we did this in AP. For APs, for three consecutive terms of AP, we write T2 minus T1, T3 minus T2. So this formula we use, this formula for APs when three consecutive terms are given, and we use this formula for GP when three consecutive terms are given. This is the example of this formula, this one. The first, second and third terms of a GP are this, this and this. This is T1, this is T2, this is T3, where K is positive, find K and R. Since three consecutive terms are given, so I will use this formula to solve this question. T2 is 2k, T1 is this, T3 is this and T2 is this, so we have this equation. After cross multiplication, we have value of k, and after getting the value of k, substitute k either here or here to get r. So when you will do cross multiplication, you will get k, and you can substitute k here or here to get r. I already have discussed that r can be in percentage. Like an 8%, 8% increase means R is 108%, which is 1.08. A 6% decrease means R is 94%, like 0.94. The amount in dollar is 80% of the previous year, neither increase nor decrease, so R is 80%, like 0.8. We already have discussed the structure of GP. A geometric progression in which all the terms are positive has common ratio R. The sum of the first n terms is less than 90% sum to infinite. This is the given information, sum of the first n term means Sn is less than 90% sum to infinite. This is here. We have to show this thing. So with the help of this given information, we can easily prove this. We just need to put the formula of Sn here and the formula of S infinity here. So we can cancel one minus r here. We can cancel this a and this a. So we have this thing. So after canceling these two a's and this one minus r with this one minus r, we have this thing. And finally, we have shown this thing. This is what we had to show. Let me just edit this sign. This is greater sign. Because this negative will convert, change the sign to greater sign. Next question. The first, second, and third terms of a GP are this, this, and this. Given that all the terms of the GP are positive, calculate the value of K. So this is very simple. We just need to use this formula of R. When three consecutive terms are given, always use this formula to make the calculation simple. After cross multiplication, we have the value of K. Since it's given that all terms are positive, so K must be positive. This is rejected. Now we need sum to infinite of this progression. For that we need the value of R. So we need to put 12 either here or here. So I substituted K 12 here and I got R 2 upon 3. Now I need the first term. This is the first term, 2K plus 3. So 2K plus 3 is here, 1 minus R is here, K is 12. So this is the sum to infinite of this GP. Can check this solution. First get K, then get R, and then use sum to infinite formula and get the answer. Next question. A geometric progression has a third term of 20 and a sum to infinity which is 3 times the sum, the first term. Like third term is 20 means T3 and T3 is R2. Sum to infinite is 3 times the first term, so this is also given. So these two things are given, these two conditions are given. So with the help of this condition, we have the value of A in terms of R, and with the help of this condition, we have this formula. We can cancel these two A's and we can get the value of R straight away. Let me make this calculation simple. Since A is constant, so we can cancel A. We can cancel the constants. So by solving this equation, we have 1 minus R is 3. So 1 minus R, 1 upon 3 is 1 minus R. Therefore, R is 2 upon 3. And A will be 20 upon this thing. And we had to find the first term. So this is the first term. First get R and then get A. This is A. Next question. In a GP, the second term is 9 less than the first term. This statement means that T2 is T1 minus 9. This information is there. The second term is 9 less than the first term. For example, if the first term is 100, then second term will be 91. So you have to write 9 here. Second term is 9 less than the first term. So when you will use this condition here, you'll get this equation. the sum of the next condition, the sum of the second and third terms is 30. This is the condition number one, this is here, and this is the condition number two. Let me erase the second condition because this will make calculations difficult. I'm writing second condition here. T2 plus T3 is 30. This is the second condition. So this is the simplified form of the first condition. T2, T1 is A, so R is this. And this is here. This is here. And this is here. So this is the second condition. T2 is A minus 9. And T3 is AR square. And we have the value of R. So by solving these two equations, we can get the values of A and R. We need the first term, in fact. We don't need the value of R. This is 30A. Because after taking the LCM, you will multiply this A here. So that's the final answer. You have to reject this because it says that all terms are positive. So A should be 27 because 27 minus 9 makes the second term positive. If you take this value of A is here, then second term will be negative and it says all terms are positive. So this is the right answer. Next question. The first term of a GP is under root 3 and the second term is 2 cos theta. So this is T1 and this is T2, where theta lies in this range. Find the set of values of theta for which the progression is convergent. For converge GP, R must be between minus 1 and 1. This is the condition for the converge GP or converge GPs. So we just need to find the value of R with the help of these two things. So R is T2 upon T1, which is this. We just need to put R here. So when we will substitute this R here, we'll get this thing. Now we just need to separate cos theta. For that we need to multiply this here and here, and then we need to divide this and this by 2 because we need to make cos theta subject. Now we need to take the basic angle, we need to find the basic angle. So cos theta is root 3 upon 2, so basic angle is pi by 6. This domain means cos is in first and second quadrant. So when cos is in first quadrant, the answer is pi by 6. When cos is positive, so this is the answer, pi by 6. When cos is in second quadrant, the answer will be pi minus pi by 6, which is 5 pi by 6. So larger number is here and smaller number is here. This answer is pi by 6. This is the basic angle, pi by 6. So this will be 5 pi by 6. So this is the way to get the range of values of theta for GP to be converged. You can take a screenshot of the solution because this solution, this question is very important. After this step, first find alpha and observe the domain. So theta is in like first quadrant and second quadrant. Cos is negative, so it must be in second quadrant. Cos is positive, so this must be in first quadrant. In first quadrant, answer is pi by 6. In second quadrant, answer is 5 pi by 6. Well, this is over. And I hope This lecture will help you to understand the concepts of geometric progressions. I'm extremely thankful to my student, Ms. Laiba Gulzar, who helped me to make this lecture. Indeed, she is an outstanding student. May Allah Pak bless her always. Ameen. An important advice for me and for everyone, we must be cool. Good luck. And Allah Hafiz.